Yo, what's up, guys? Yeah, pokeaim here, and today I have my first UU live with UU Aegislash and UU Tyranitar in Pokemon Sword and Shield. So this is pretty exciting. I'm pretty excited. I built this team in like 2 minutes, so it's not anything great. I wanted to make a new alt as well, so I figured I could use it for laddering up, but basically it's Specs Aegislash, Band Tyranitar. You guys can check out the team yourself on pokeaimMD.com. The link is down below. Also, my Crimson Chin clip went up on my Pokeaim Clips channel, so that link is down below too if y'all want to check that out. Feel free to subscribe. We're trying to get that channel to 1,000 subs. But I got Volt Switch Rotom, physically defensive with Thunder Wave to help Abandoned Tyranitar and Specs Aegislash, specially defensive Parting Shot Incineroar, Scarf Gengar, and then Defog Noivern. A really bad Defog Noivern EV spread as well, but I figured the team a little bit weak to basically everything. So I wanted to at least be able to switch in on Heracross and Conkeldurr once, because all these Pokemon are down. It's insane. UU is just crazy right now. If you haven't seen my thoughts on the tier changes, I uploaded a video late last night. Feel free to go ahead and check that out. And yeah, if you aren't subscribed, we're on our way to 246,000, on our way to 300,000 by the end of the year, hopefully. So you see Tyranitar, you see his team. You see Aegislash Shadow Ball and you see their team. It is absolutely insane. I'm pretty weak to their Toxtricity. Again, I'm just trying to make a new account. I wanted to ladder up. I didn't feel like playing 15, 16, whatever, 100 I might be. Just because I want to jump into the new tier almost like it's a road to top 10, kind of, right? But just in case they start talking so that they don't get distracted. Shadow Ball is amazing here. I love Incineroar as a lead just because Intimidate's very good versus my opponent, and it can actually live a hit from Toxtricity if it specs and knock it off. Tyranitar clicks buttons too, and I am very good with this. I go right out into my Aegislash right here. It deals with the close combat. I don't really care about rocks. My team actually doesn't have rocks, but I click Spec Shadow Ball, and ideally, I mean, this is modest. So I got Specs, but then I got like Close Combat for opposing Tyranitar, and then just Shadow Sneak for like a weakened Gengar or something. We just click Spec Shadow Ball. Bro, you dead. You're dead. There's no way. You dead. 87? Hey, that's fine, bro. I will take a couple more right now. But yeah, like if you've been watching my videos, you might as well subscribe. We're on our way. This might be Volt Switch plus Close Combat. It could just be Iron Head plus CC as well. Either way, I'm just going to Shadow Ball everything coming in. Salazzle's checked by Tyranitar, so I'm not as worried about that. Golisopod gets checked by Noivern as well as Rotom. Tyranitar, if it comes in, this Mon is a giant threat. It's going to die. So I'm very happy that Mon is dead. I'm extremely happy that Mon is dead. I tested a few games as well on like a higher alt. Also, the fact that they gave me this, it means that their crunch switching is very limited, because Hitmonlee does not take crunch very well. It's easily 2 KO'd. So I will go Tyranitar. If they click Toxic, very good play on their part, as they go for Nasty Plot, so they can't really do much from here. And we'll just crunch, because crunch kills Kobali under that range. Flamethrower actually does a good chunk, I'm honest. And yeah, we're just setting up for my boy Aegislash to come in. Hitmonlee, I'm going to make sure that I have Noivern checked, or in. I'm going to make sure I have Noivern around and ready to deal with that. Gengar kind of looks expendable, but to be honest, no, it's Hitmonlee that's expendable. Hitmonlee is very expendable. I don't want to go directly into the Mon I actually have to, though. Right here, I guess I could afford to go out to Gengar, because if they go for High Jump Kick, I'm good. If they have CC, they did have Unburden. I didn't notice the gem, so they do have CC. We'll go right back out in Incineroar. We're basically just Intimidate Shuffling. I have the Heavy Duty Boots, so I don't have to worry about rocks as well if they go for knockoff. And I'm pretty positive I live CC, so I'm just going to knock him out with Flare Blitz here. Pick up my KO, and then... Oh, they try to predict my Gengar. Sorry, buddy. Yeah, get out of here. Good. So, let's get another one. I'm trying to... My Tyranitar set is... It's Crunch, Stone Edge, Low Kick, and Heavy Slam. Heavy Slam does like 83 to 90 something percent to Galarian Weezing, physically defensive, and Low Kick does 102% minimum to they allowed Crawdon back in here too, to Kobalion. So it's really, really sick. Oh, and I love Tyranitar in this game, man. I'm just gonna click Stone Edge with my boy, or I can click Low Kick because of Rhyperior and whatnot. So you have some very threatening Pokemon. Aegislash looks stupid good in this game too. Just clicking Flash Cannon, really. I mean, they have two resists, but three. But it's still very good. And I love Tyranitar early because it kind of says, unless you lead off with Rhyperior, it gets a kill. You lead off with the wrong Pokemon. But I should be safe and scout for the Focus Blast. Focus Blast is something my opponent can go for. So they could also go a Scavalier here too. I'm gonna scout for Focus Blast. I'm gonna go Aegislash as they go out to Rhyperior. Now what I could do here is I could actually Flash Cannon, even if they Earthquake and knock me out. That would mean that I could Stone Edge and kill every member of their team with Tyranitar. But that would rely on me hitting a million Stone Edges. So I'm gonna make the Rotom play, even if they opt to go for Stealth Rock, as I just go for the safe Earthquake. And Rotom's a Pokemon they do not switch in very well to anyway. With Sand Up, they can eat one hit. I could also Thunder Wave here, but there's no reason to. I'm just gonna click Hydro Pump. I figured Comfy would come out. And unfortunately for my opponent, Comfy is hardwalled by Aegislash. Now, if they double, I'm okay with that. As they go for Leech Seed, which is smart. Now, they could U-turn as well. I want to make the Tyranitar play because I'm anticipating them to want to go out to Aegislash. Or, I guess Crawdaunt works too. Now, if they're Jolly, they knock me out. But otherwise, I think Banded Low Kick still kills them. I'm going to be honest, it's 60 base power. But let's find out. Crawdaunt. Loki does 94 to 111. Stone Edge is a guarantee. Okay, I'm clicking it. Ah, they're Jolly. So I lost my Tyranitar there. Oh, they're Jolly Life Orb too. I mean, it's fine. Again, Rotom has no switch-ins. And I can Pain Split on Rhyperior when it comes out. So if they want to, if I'm them, I actually click Knock Off here. Or trying to play around. Ah, man, my poor Tyranitar. I killed everything. It's okay. Aegislash kills everything too. Probably shouldn't have risked that. Though that Mon is very tough for me to switch into. But now... this Mon is very tough for them to switch into, so we're just going to click the Shadow Ball. As they go Rhyperior, I should have Flash Cannon there because they do have the Exploud, but we do a million to Rhyperior, and I'm just going to Shadow Ball again. If they go Exploud or Incineroar, they don't go Exploud, thankfully. Gengar might even end game this too. They go Incineroar to take so much damage, my gosh. I love that now that Tyranitar is dead, I lose a Mon whenever Exploud comes out. That's incredible. Well played on my part. Luckily, Noivern has like very little use. That's their special Dark Pulse. Why? But I mean, I guess with Rhyperior being at 14%, as you can see, I have a really bad Noivern set, but it's like physically defensive, just faster than Scolipede to Air Slash. Hopefully, I land so I can 2 AKO or knock them out. Good. So we get rid of them. Obviously, X-Plot's a problem because of Scrappy Boom Burst. Oh, they acknowledge the fact that X-Plot's a problem. Good, good, good. I'm just going to get some damage for Sludge Bomb to be able to knock him out as I get a flinch. Not really going for that, but we'll take it. Goodbye. And I could Focus Blast here. I could also give them a Choice Scarf, but that wouldn't, they would be faster than me. I think Focus Blast makes the most sense because it doesn't allow a Scavalier in, but a Scavalier isn't the biggest problem because I have Incineroar. So I'm going to Sludge Wave and get rid of the biggest threat to my team. Incineroar comes out. They are special. My own Incineroar is going to help me deal with this. Got to keep this thing healthy too. I think we just make the Rotom play. Them being special is actually annoying. I guess, is that just an attempt to deal with this? We're in a Thunder Wave on Comfy coming in. I don't want them Giga Draining me, so I'll make the Aegislash play. Actually, I can Pain Split on Incineroar, so I'm going to Volt Switch because I don't want them doubling out into Crawdaunt there and bring out my Aegislash and just click Shadow Ball as they go for Leech Seed. And yeah, once again, we'll just click Shadow Ball. As they go Scavalier, expecting the Flash Cannon. So that's great because that is the mon on their team that could actually... oh, I got a Spidef drop too. Oh, that's amazing, man. Aegislash busted. I've been... yo, when I was building this team, I changed Aegislash from Bandit to Specs to Bandit to Specs like a million times. Dude. Yo, I'm clicking it again. Shoot. Look at all these Spidef drops. What's a counter, man? Get out of here. So Crawdaunt is 100% faster. I don't think I'll lose to this Mon, so I'm gonna go Incineroar. As good as it is, I feel like I can just Shadow Ball and then Sludge Bomb spam. And I'll CC here, in case worst comes to worst. They should Aqua Jet, but I mean Liquidate, whatever. Yeah, we go Rotom, we live this hit. I Volt Switch here. I Shadow Ball on the, I Sludge Wave to win the game, basically. But I go for Spec Shadow Ball. I pick up another KO. Crawdaunt comes out. And then, excuse me, I Shadow Ball. I Volt Switch into Shadow Ball to win. I think that's enough. Okay, go ahead and give me that Mon. Thank you very much. Oh, it didn't die. Huh. Okay. I made a mistake here. But I think Pain Split is fine. Yeah, because they get a lot back. But I definitely made a mistake right there. my thought process was, oh, I don't want them to, like, I don't even know what my thought process was there. Like, I'm trying to think, why'd I do that? Oh, I didn't want them to go, like, try and make a cheeky Crawdon play, but now I'm messing up. So let me go with this and hopefully not mess up this time. That was a really poor play on my part. They go hardest Cavalier, though, which I think was a poor play on their part because now I Sludge Wave sweep them. Yeah. Just sack you. Go you and click Sludge Wave. No way you die to Aqua Jet. Especially from a Jolly one? No way. And Sludge Wave wins. So, yeah, a little bit of a misplay on my part for sure. I think I thought that they would go Crawdon and I wanted to try and be on top of that play. But I did not. Or I was not. Good game. So, definitely a misplay. And I also misplayed my Tyranitar because I was like, oh yeah, there's no way, man. They're going to be adamant Crawdon. That mon's powerful. Shouldn't have done that. I love that my opponent basically did exactly what I did. Let me toss on a whole bunch of broken mons and see what happens. And I love it. Rotom is phenomenal in this game. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 Pokemon checked by Rotom. Rotom is going to lead 2. Get in my... I'll charge pump here. We'll get a Noivern now because Noivern only deals with this in Keldeo. But I can defog on Noivern. Keeping Rotom's item is nice for Talonflame. Let me just go for U-turn here to knock them out as they go Grimmsnarl. Oh, the goat is coming in, baby. Looks like they're sub. Oh, I should have put Infiltrator on this thing. No, because they're going to sub-com mine with Keldeo. So if I hit Stone Edge, I get a kill. But a Heavy Slam doesn't miss, so I'm just going to click it instead. I'm not trying to miss. We deny rocks, which is pretty cool. I'm very, very weak to Lycanroc. I wonder how much this does. Good damage. Shoot, good damage. Aegislash has like no role in this game. So I'm just going to go out into it. Click Flash Cannon. As luckily they go for Taunt, expecting me to be ESD. So they don't get up a Light Screen, which is going to be pretty big for Gengar. And I'm assuming maybe Keldeo, as well as Rotom. But I'm assuming maybe Keldeo might want to come out, or they go hard Gengar. Incineroar is here for that Pokemon, but the problem with going Incineroar is I want Incineroar for Intimidate on Lycanroc. I guess if I keep Rotom at 100%, I can do that. So we're gonna go Incineroar now, and then we'll go Gengar and click Shadow Ball. Yeah, assuming they're not Specs. Sash. I should be able to pick up a KO of Gengar here with my Shadow Ball. They might be Sash. Okay, they're not. Great. And they don't get the Cursed Body, which is awesome. I'm very, 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 very weak to Lycanroc, man. I am extremely weak to Lycanroc. As they go for Swords Dance. Let's see if we can outplay a couple turns of a Celeroc. And, oh, we did. It was one turn. One turn was all the turns we needed to outplay. So, great. That's gone. We have Rotom right here and ready for you as they go for a Calm Mind. Go out to you and click Trick. Maybe get a Cursed Body on you, possibly Surf. Go Rotom and Thunder Wave. Big damage. Ooh, they were still faster. They could have gotten a nasty roll. It doesn't matter because Tyranitar will beat Talonflame, so. I'll just Volt Switch here. Get some sand up to chip away at Keldeo even more. And then I would have went out and then I would have sacked Rotom, went out to my Noivern. Hopefully didn't get flinched while clicking, didn't miss while clicking Air Slash. And if that did miss, I would have went out to Aegislash, click the Shadow Sneak. Probably wouldn't have killed Keldeo, but Sand would have at that point. And that would have made Tyranitar B versus Talonflame. And that is not a match that Talonflame likes because it did not get close combat. Look at the Stone Edge and look at their team. But I also love Incineroar in this because it just clicks knockoff on everything. And I'm going to go early. Incineroar, attempt to get in. This could be Trick Room, I guess, too. Huh, this also could be Zoroark. Doesn't matter, I still knock off here. I'm Spidef, so I live every hit from both of them. Whether it be Focus Blast, Low Kick because of the Intimidate and whatnot. I basically don't knock out Torkoal from full. So I want to be able to. At that percentage, I might knock it out with Bandit. Actually, that's probably Spidef. As they opt to body press here. Just going to Air Slash. Actually, I'm going to U-turn because I have Rotom. And Rotom doesn't have much use besides coming in on Torkoal. Like, it really doesn't. It's not like I can't just Volt Switch here as they go Goodra or hard Charizard? Huh? Gengar comes out because I'm Choice Scarf. And I just click Sludge Wave and knock them out. They're probably Scarf Charizard too. I don't know why they went hard Charizard on a Rotom. Maybe they expected Defog so they could Solar Beam me. So I'm gonna give that to them. But we get rid of a Giant Threat. Swords that... Yeah, okay. Sure, Zoroark, if you want to do that to me. Okay. Yeah, I'll Zoroark for sure. Hmm. As a dark... Wow. Very surprised at Dark Pulse there. We'll Sludge Wave. Because Tyranitar can beat the... that's okay. Like I said, Tyranitar can beat... I'm very surprised at Dark Pulse there. That was a really good play. But Incineroar has a lot more use than Noivern in this game anyway. And I don't mind playing a game of rocks. Especially when I go out to... I literally go Tyranitar now and I click Bandage Stone Edge and they give me a Pokemon. This adamant choice, bam, bro. And you know, Spec Shadow Ball also kills everything. I really hope this hits actually because I could lose to Goodra. So thank you very much for hitting. I appreciate you. We're going to go hard Aegislash on one of these Psychic types coming in. Bro, I saw a calc today that was so funny. They showed me the... someone showed me the... what is it? Choice Ban... Tyranitar Stone Edge versus Skarmory, and I was like, bro, I've known this calc since 2007, but it's just funny that people are like figuring it out now. It's just very funny to me anyway. I like Rotom, just in case, yeah, they had that set in particular, and we'll just Thunder Wave here. Actually, Pain Split first is fine. I didn't want to go hard Aegislash. Rotom has, like I said, the least amount of use. Dude, that does not matter. You can go ahead and get Thunder Wave, and then you can get Crunch like the rest of your team, bro. Dude, it do not matter. I could even just sack Aegislash now if I really want to, but I'm not. It's not like they're a Combine Trick Room, so. But then they would have to have something to hit Incineroar, so it's fine. I'll scout for it, though. I will. I mean, I knock you out with Shadow Sneak, so I will scout for it. I'll scout for a random Focus Blast. Why not? Wow, they were actually Calm Mind Trick. And they're Regenerator too, not even Magic Guard? Man. This trash out of here. Get this side out of here. Ah, nice. Still at 100 too. Deserved 100. Incineroar, Aegislash, and Tyranitar should be enough as well to deal with the Goodra. Oh, for sure. Now that they gave me a knockoff on it. The Goo! Yeah, I wanted to get a Tyranitar, but it's fine. I'm liking this, man. Aegislash and Tyranitar just look really good. Like, as long, obviously, this isn't the best type of team, I think, to use them on. And I can't wait to see how the metagame progresses. And I'm fairly confident Aegislash going back up to OU, or it's going to be banned or whatever. You know, obviously, there's no way this stuff is. This guy has some demons, all right? When I say some demons, I mean some demons. Ninjas. That's a sleeper pick, because it actually is pretty good versus me with Swords Dance, Leech Life, Dual Wing Beat, and Night Slash. It's actually really, really good versus me. But the great thing is Aegislash has hopefully... There's a chance that I'm faster than him, and I can just knock him out with Shadow Ball. Aegislash is really good in this game, though. So I'll make the Noivern play just to be safe right now, and I'll find out later if they... Oh, God. Okay. That's great. Like, they have no flying resist. But I made the Noivern play. I could have just spec Shadow Balled and probably KO'd them. Because it had Scrappy, so it could have smacked me. Ah, shout out to my defense EVs right there. Making me live. I don't know if I would have lived it naturally, but... Shout out to my defense EVs, man. I bet you I live Bullet Punch from a champ, too. Yeah, like I said, this is a really jank... This is a really jank... Noivern, but I wanted a Heracross and Conkeldurr Switch, and I use Air Slash because it KOs Heracross. I don't care about, you know, hitting everything else. Bro, imagine having the worst the worst set on Noivern ever. But I go Rotom, they have no ground type, so I can just Volt Switch with it, and the Mon that comes in on Rotom, oh well, you better pray it doesn't die. Heavy Slam is gonna be so clean in this game soon. We're gonna keep Noivern though. I could always Roost on Sirfetch as they make the nice U-turn play. Makes sense. They could get in Machamp here. I'm faster than Adamant Machamp, not Jolly. So maybe I shouldn't have made my... I made my Rotom faster than Adamant Max Speed Tyranitar. I felt like that was a good benchmark. I wonder how Dragon Dance Tyranitar would be. That actually sounds pretty nice because it gets a few free SDs. Hard Tyranitar! Bro, you could have a million resists and it's still going to kill everything. Alright, let's click that Stone Edge. Don't miss. This is going to kill. This is going to kill. That's the homie, Banded Tyranitar. I'm sorry, you never played ADV or DPP, but you were missing out, man, on when this dude... Oh, Choice... They didn't even have Stone Edge. Oh, shoot. You about to do some damage to me, aren't you? Low kick. Heavy slam. Gengar. Click Shadow Ball, so I shouldn't sack that. Rotom comes in on... Okay, if I keep Incineroar alive, I shouldn't lose to Ninjas. So I can afford to go Rotom. Especially if they low kick or heavy slam. They go for Crunch, which is just as good. They get a defense drop, but I don't doubt the next one. It's going to do like 54, 55. So I'm a Thunder Wave here in case they opt to go for that play. Thunder Wave is no drawback. Oh, never mind. I die. But I click Choice Band Heavy Slam now. Two KOs Weezing. If they're not physically defensive, Okos. Bro. Show me some damage, baby. 23. That sucked that I lost Rotom because I could have Thunder Wave the Ditto and it would not have been a threat. And now I have to deal with a scary Pokemon here. I can risk Aegislash. All right, Noivern. You did your job. You deserve a good rest. They said no. If they're Assault Vest, this is a problem, man. I'm just going to spec Shadow Ball and pray they're not Assault Vest. Ah, they ate it. Dude, why am I being killed by elemental punches, dude? Freaking elemental hero over here. Anyway, Shadow Ball is my play. It's not looking that great. It's not looking that great because of the defense drop and the crit. I don't mind T-Tar putting me down, but I wish it did not. So they might Focus Blast considering I have two dark types in the back. I'm gonna go for Shadow Ball. I could also win a speed tie, so there's a lot that could happen here. That could actually let me win, and there's also a lot that could happen here that could make me lose. But I luckily got the speed tie versus Ditto. They did get the cursed body, which is very annoying because Ninjask is scary. But I'll go Incineroar, get up the Intimidate and Flare Blitz. Yeah, I know they're trying. This mod low key is scary. It can run heavy duty boots plus dual wing beat. Now, dual wing beat's pretty weak unless you're Scyther or whatever, but yeah, dude, you're getting blitzed. Don't you dare crit me. I don't know if I died or crit, I'm gonna be honest. I might not. If it has U-turn, it's annoying too. Oh my gosh, it does. Okay, Espeon comes out. It's not really much Espeon could do to me. All right, I think I win as long as I make it so Ninjas doesn't SD up in my face. I win with, Tyranitar. I'm assuming Heavy Slam is good. This is a bug. I'm assuming it gets squashed. That's what I'm assuming here. That's Wish Life Orb. What the hell is their set? I could be wrong. Ooh, terrain. That's cool. I'm just gonna Flare Blitz for some nothing. Some no damage. Sludge Wave. And then Heavy Slam win, ideally. Or Crunch Wind, depending on... They can't confuse me because of Misty Terrain, thankfully. They might have Misty Explosion, though, which would be pretty funny. Yo, do I die? Do I lose if they have Misty Explosion? I probably do. They definitely have Misty... I'm about to lose to Ninjas, because there's no way that kills Gengar. Okay. Okay, good, good. It might have killed Gengar. Man, I lost anyway, didn't I? I definitely did. Did they have speed boost? They did. And they protect. Wait, they protected first. Huh. Hold up. Does this kill Ninjas? Yo, it might. It lived up with his Focus Sash. Oh, this mon sucks. Let me make sure you die to sand. I ain't gonna let anything die. I'm 2-0 it. I am too. If you crit me, so help me. Ah, I am 2-0. I don't think that's a set to run on Ninjas, but whatever. That guy had some jank Pokemon, and they still almost beat me. This is what I'm talking about, man. A Violite the team. This team looks so ugly. Why is there a Haunter? Bro, grow up. Haunter's like the dude living with the mom to like 40 something. I mean, there's a completely big difference between that and then helping your parents when you're older. There's a completely big difference, but the one who like super depends and doesn't go out and we watch in all the movies, that's what that is. Love Rotom in this game. Volt Switch plus that. Bandit Tyranitar is going to be amazing in this. We're gonna go hard Incineroar here. I'm not about to get put down by Energy Ball, because Haunter's actually, like, if you guys knew about Haunter, it's actually pretty strong at base 115 special attack. I'm a parting shot here as opposed to knocking off, because I don't want them going hard Terrakion exactly. And now this is a position where I get an Aegislash, and I think I click CC. I'm going to click CC here, because if they go hard Blissey, then I can spam Flash Cannon as they go Skarm. So they're probably here thinking, oh, okay, this guy is physically offensive, so we're good now. But little do they know, I'm about to click Shadow Ball right after. Little do they know. Alright, let's get Stone Edge. Let the Stone Edges fly. Skarmory gets 2 KO. Let the Stone Edges fly. Bro, if this lands... Woo! 56%! Oh, that looked kind of clean. Hold up. Oh, Protect. This dude really did bring it back to ADV. What now, though? You going Terrakion and taking a million? Bro, give me Skarmory, for sure. That way I don't even have to bluff on my Aegislash. Give me Skarmory. Oh, go hard Terrakion and get crit, so I do 80%. At this point, I really do like the Rotom play. I feel like it can come in and pivot. It'll live one hit. If it's Choice Band, it'll live one hit. They might Stone Edge, or they go Magneton. Okay, they go Magneton, which isn't bad. We Volt Switch here. As they are Specs, oh my gosh. And they did the exact same thing. But my friend. If there's anything we know about my friend, young Choice Band Tyranitar, it's that it clicks Stone Edge and gets kills. So we're going to click this Stone Edge right here. You can protect with your... Ooh. Dude, teleport out, bro. I was trying to kill you. That's so funny, man. That's so funny. I don't want to risk Noivern. Why not? Because they might Earthquake. They actually CC, which isn't too bad for me. Considering I could U-turn here and just keep up momentum. I think I knock off, because Terrakion is way less of a threat if it's not choice locked. Yeah, perfect. And this thing isn't a threat if it's not choice locked either. Parting shot. As they teleport here. They might Earthquake, but because I showed my initial switching, I doubt it. I think they're going to click Stone Edge. So I'm going to make the switch into Aegislash, and I'm going to click Shadow Ball, or Flash Cannon into a KO Skarmory, excuse me. As they do Earthquake, smart play. What would they go to predict my Noivern? I'm going to Flash Cannon as they double Earthquake. Okay, I shouldn't have made that play, I guess. So I made the wrong play, but I mean, I'm still in a winning position because Gengar looks stupid good in this game. And I get a kill right now. Which Stone Edge could crunch. I'll crunch to be safe. Because Gengar can win with defense drops. I don't think that matters. Siri, nobody's talking to you. Because Gengar, yeah, crunch to a KO Skarm. Skarm being healthy doesn't really matter, because that just means I get more healthy with my Mon. As I go for T-Bolt. Is that analytic? Gosh. So we get rid of you. Gengar clicks Shadow Ball almost. Haunter comes out. He's probably going to Sludge Bomb. Yo, dude, you got way too many Pokemon that are threatening. This thing specs too. I'm going to knock off Terrakion if possible. Or just kill Haunter. I would be okay with killing Haunter. Cool. You can still Close Combat Blissey, which is really nice. Magneton comes out. Depending... This mon is actually problematic, I'll be honest. I'll sack Noivern in here. Say Thunderbolt, I click Focus Blast. This is probably sturdy too. It's probably not even analytic. It's probably sturdy. It's probably sturdy, isn't it? Let's see. I hate that I have to click Focus Blast here. It might be Spec sturdy. I don't know. Perfect, it wasn't. Sick, okay. So Terrakion comes out. It's probably gonna Stone Edge. I don't see an endgame where I don't click. Actually, I know what I do. I go Incineroar and Stone Edge. Perfect. Cause I Sludge Wave to knock out you. Cause I could go Blissey, exactly. And then I could Shadow Ball. Perfect, okay. I sack Tyranitar here. I just go for Crunch. Because Volt Switch would knock out Skarm. As they Brave Bird me, Volt Switch picks off Skarmory now. Does it not? Does Volt Switch not pick off Skarm? Okay, I can't have them. I can't have me going Gengar and them not going for Volt Switch. So I'm gonna Hydro Pump here. Yeah, okay, perfect. I think that was the right series of plays. And then we go out to Gengar. We just click Shadow Ball to win. And this endgame was a little bit fishy. Wasn't as clear as I guess it could have been. Good game. Gengar put in Rock though. Band of Tyranitar was beautiful. I threw away my Aegislash. I shouldn't have. I got a little bit cocky there with Aegislash. But yeah, Specs Aegislash, Band of Tyranitar, they are definitely demons in the UU tier. I hope you guys all enjoyed. Let me know your thoughts on them. Leaving a like, subscribing, you know, all that stuff helps me out. Nice little comment. I'll see y'all next time. Goodbye, friends.